Hello students, welcome to the Pole Science of Class 11 Arts, and today we will proceed with the second new topic introduced by the CBSE in the present year syllabus of Pole Science. In the previous class, we had started discussing about the first new topic, that was the electoral reforms in Indian politics from the chapter Election and Representation, where we discussed about the concept briefly and we also discuss about two questions carrying 1 and 4 mark each. So today we will discuss about the second new topic, that is judicial overreach, and this is from the chapter Judiciary from book 1, that is Indian Constitution at Work. So let us proceed then. So, related to judicial overreach, when judiciary assumes the roles and functions of the legislature and executive, thus diluting the concept of separation of powers, it becomes judicial overreach. Unrestrained activism on the part of judiciary often leads to its overreach. We all know that Article 142 and judicial review have been put to many constructive uses, but some actions like declaring the NJAC, that stands for National Judicial Appointment Commission, unconstitutional as it tried to apply checks on judicial power, highlights the needs of judicial restraints in the exercise of judicial review. Clear? So regarding judicial overreach, sometimes when judiciary assumes the role of roles and functions of the legislature and executive, thus diluting the separation of powers, it becomes judicial overreach. Unrestrained activism on the part of judiciary often leads to its overreach. As we know that there are three organs, namely the legislature, the executive and the judiciary. So we also know that these three organs are independent and they can have a look into each other's work and development process, but they cannot interfere. So at some times, when judiciary assumes the roles and functions of legislature and executive, thus diluting the concept of separation of powers, it becomes judicial overreach. So this judicial overreach is what? When the judiciary assumes the roles and functions of the legislature and executive. At that particular moment only, when it assumes the roles and functions of legislature and executive, it dilutes the concepts of separation of powers. That means it do not follows the concept of separation of powers, because all these three organs are working on the separation of powers, because these three organs are independent of each other and no one can interfere into each other's work, but they can have an eye on each other's work. So unrestrained activism on the part of judiciary often leads to its overreach. So these are all related to what? The unrestrained activism. These are all the unrestrained activism or activist activities as a part of judiciary that can lead to its overreach. So we all know that Article 142 and judicial review have been put to many constructive uses. Clear? So according to Article 142 of the Indian Constitution and the judicial review, these two things have actually been put to many constructive uses. Constructive uses means this Article 142 and judicial review have been made to work in very good work or developmental work. But some actions like declaring the NJAC, like the National Judicial Appointment Commission, unconstitutional, as it tried to apply checks on judicial power, highlights the need for judicial restraints in the exercise of judicial review. So sometimes it was like that, as we all know that through the Article 142 and judicial review, many good works and many developmental works were done. But during one such negative instance, that means through this Article 142 and judicial review, the judiciary actually declared the NJAC, that means National Judicial Appointment Commission, as unconstitutional, which was not a very good work or good thing which was done, because it took the advantage of the judicial review and Article 142, through which it unconstitutionally declared the NJC as unconstitutional. So regarding that only, the judicial overreach, when the judiciary sometimes crosses limits regarding and taking the role of supreme, so at that time it can be termed as judicial overreach. That means whatever the functions and powers are given to you, after that also if you are using some other powers by overtaking the constitution, at that time this particular thing can be termed as judicial overreach. Clear? And regarding the question related to judicial overreach is, write a short note on judicial overreach. What do you mean by judicial overreach? And apart from that, this question might come in other form also, like judiciary assumes the roles and functions of the legislature and executive. Explain. Then when judiciary assumes or do the roles and functions of legislature and executive, at that particular moment only, that the assuming the role and function of the legislature and executive is termed as judicial overreach. So when judiciary assumes the roles and functions of the legislature and executive, it thus dilutes the concept of separation of powers. That means it does not follow the concept of separation of powers. And as we know that the three organs, namely the legislature, the judiciary and the executive, all works on the principle of separation of powers, because these three organizations are independent and they work according to their wish. But there is a system of checks and balances according to which these three organs can have an eye on each other's work and development process. But when judiciary assumes the roles and functions of legislature, that means overtaking the work of legislature and executive, and in this way it is doing what? It is also diluting the separation of concept. Whatever the concept of separation of powers is there, it is also diluting. It is not abiding by that concept. So it, at that particular moment only, it becomes judicial overreach. So unrestrained activism on the part of judiciary often leads to its overreach. That means these are all unrestrained activism. That means you cannot do that, but you are doing that. So it can lead to, at that particular moment when you are doing that particular thing unrestrainedly, at that moment only it can be called as an overreach. We all know that Article 142 and judicial review have been put to many constructive uses, but some actions like declaring the NJAC unconstitutional as it tried to apply checks on judicial power highlights the need for judicial restraints in the exercise of judicial review. So at every moment we have seen that Article 142 judicial review have been made to work in very positive uses. But at a particular moment when the judiciary used and termed the NJAC as unconstitutional, and why it has declared the NJAC as unconstitutional, because it tried to apply checks on judicial power highlights itself. Clear? Had applied checks that what are the works are being done regarding judiciary. Due to that only, unconstitutionally, through the Article 142 and judicial review, the NJC was declared unconstitutional, which was not positive at all. So at this instance also we can say that this has reached the judicial overreach limit. So with this, I will wind up today's topic related to the discussions of the second new topic introduced by the CBSE, that is judicial overreach. So please make a note down of the point also, whatever it is discussed. And along with that, you also make a note down of the question that we discussed today related to the judicial overreach. Or question might come like this also, that judiciary assumes the roles of functions and executive. Explain. That means whenever the judiciary assumes the roles and functions of legislature and executive, what it is doing? It is reaching the judicial overreach. And how it is reaching the judicial overreach? As it is diluting, as it is mixing the powers and functions of all the three organs, because all the three organs works on the principle of separation of powers. So when it is overreaching that, that means it is diluting the concept of separation of powers. So please go through these lines, whatever we have discussed today. So with this, I will wind up today's topic. Thank you.